Hello everyone and welcome back to Dark Souls 3. My name is Revonlieke, let us continue on with the story of Dark Souls 3. On this episode we shall go through the Art Struggling Keep. I don't think we have... we don't have anything other than the souls that we need to read. Soul of Osiris, so this is the dragon, the consumed king, the dragon with the baby. One of the twisted souls dipped in strength, Osiris went mad trying to harness his royal blood with great purpose, leading him to the heretics of the Grand Archives, where he discovered the twisted force. Yeah, we already read that, alright. The next is the soul of champion Kundur. Once a champion came late to the festivities and was greeted with shrine without fire and the bell that would not toll. Indeed, and champion Kundur kinda was a chosen one, or not chosen one, but the Ashen One. And when he arrived the filing shrine with his weapon and shield, he realized that it was pitch black, and there was, I think the inclination to it is that he became Edex Kundur at some point or another. But he never found the firekeeper who was indeed hidden in the tower. Maybe he didn't find a way there, because the firekeeper or this lady here in the darker filing shrine says that there is a lady hidden or locked away, and yeah, that just happens, and you know. But the thing is that even in the darker realm of Firelink Shrine, we see the champion Kundur there, which would kind of imply that, like, why did he stay there? Why did he become the protector of Firelink Shrine or whatever have you? Alright, those are the things. Like, I don't have like every answer to everything, so I'm sorry about the... Oh right, we don't want to go here yet. Travel to here first, because I want to go through this area probably as fast as possible. Not going to spend too much time on killing things, I just want the items. I'm not sure, there should be a couple of items, like mostly redundant stuff, and I just want to show you guys this area overall. Like, there's some neat things in here for sure. We just ran past everything here, but there are some like actual items that you want to go and check for sure. And yeah, I think there's a... yeah, as you can see, a lot of items. Ember... Stalk Dung Pie. And then we go over here, and over here there is... an item. A ring, I think. Ring of Steel Protection, indeed. God damn it, don't drop! Oh my god. Oh man. You can see that there is some statues that you've never seen before in this area. Very interesting if you know what these statues are for. And if you know anything about this area overall, like the idea behind it, it does have a lot of like lore implications to it. But we will probably go into that at a later date. Totally trapped you. At a later date when we actually do some other... or get further into the Astrakhan Keep. Lightning Urn. And yeah. I think there's two of these dragon dudes over here. Yeah, freaking hell, I hate these guys so much. Good. Die! Good stuff, man. Give me your items. All them items. Alright. Ah! Itching. Face is itching. No! Don't shoot me. Wasn't there an item over here? Yeah. Titanite chunk. Not sure where this leads though. Twinkling titanite. Yay! Just what I wanted. Alright, what's this message? Ore ahead. Yeah, indeed. That's what it was. Good to know. And here I think there is a... that happens. Oh, freaking lord. Please, for the love of human kindness. I was not expecting that at all. Phew. Die. Good stuff. This is probably the place that will be one of the hardest parts of the whole area, I think. Get owned. And then there's this guy. Again. God damn it. I hate these guys so much. Their delay with the weapon is so annoying. Get owned! Thank you. First try. I used to have so much trouble with a lot of the enemies in the game. Like overall, like... when you go for like... play for the first time in Dark Souls 3, you're going to have so much trouble with the game because of Dark Souls 2 mostly. You're so used to the combat, and of course if you haven't played Dark Souls 2 at all and only been playing Dark Souls 1, then you might be a little bit better off. Overall, the difference in the game is so huge. Freaking hell. Please die. Thank you. Ah. Alright. Hardest part is over. Hardest part is over. That's good. Everything is awesome again. Just in case, I'll heal. Good stuff. And then there is the last. Last thingy-majig. And the funny thing about this whole thing is that, like, why in the heck did we teleport from fighting against the boss to the bonfire that is, like, on the other side right there? Like, why? Is the game like, okay, well, you've been playing enough, let's just teleport you to places. Like, that happens with, when you kill Yom the Giant. It's like, well, you know, there's no way that you will ever find this place, so we'll just teleport you there and continue the story. It's a kind of easing things, I guess. Twinkling through the night. Could this be a resignation? It could. You could actually probably resign your life there. Alright, we've pretty much covered this whole area. I think there's one more place we need to go. I think. I'm not completely sure. There should be an item over there. Maybe. So I'm just going to go there and see what's what. So I don't honestly remember. And you can hear that clock ringing there. That actually means that someone has killed the boss in this area. Oh, that's basically it. There wasn't anything there. Alright, so now we can go back and teleport to the actual bonfire. It didn't take us too long to cover that area. Overall, so it's fine. Completely fine. And we can travel to the Dragon King Museum. Alright, so here we are. This is actually a very annoying area to be in. Simply because of her. And what happens after you kill this guy? Well, the thing is, we need to be as fast as possible with this. Great blood, great sword. God damn it. Good. I think we were fast enough. Invaded. God damn it. Hello. That, what are you wearing? Like, what is that weapon? What is that weapon? Come on, I'm not going to come there. Oh, bleed. You devil. Really? God damn it. No! God damn it. Indeed. So that happened. Doing a let's play and someone invades you. Great. I need to be quick about this. He's dead. Now we can probably do this. Oh, freaking hell. Great! That freaking delay, man. That delay. Good. Killed you. Alright. Then there's this, or these creatures. As you can see, freaking annoying though. Freaking annoying to fight against them in here. But they do give twinkling titanites. There's so many things here. I want everything. Alright, here is a little thing. Trichester. So we shall do that. I think we need to be a little bit closer. Calamity ring. And that's basically useless ring. If you know what it does. It basically just... like... it doesn't do anything. Quite honestly. Get away from me, please. All right. Die. Good. Everything is awesome again. I freaking hate those creatures. Like, oh my god. Oh my god. Alright, I don't think there's... yeah, there's just this titanite scale. Not sure where this leads to though. Oh yeah, this leads to there. Yeah. Now I know where this leads to. This is a quick route. To the start of the area. Or start of the Arch Dragon Peak. Alright. Then, goddammit, we have so many souls and I really wouldn't want to spend the rest of the day. Dragon Slayer Spear. People are actually like beating the boss constantly here. Which is fine, of course. All right. Are you ready? Get old, man. Do your thing, man. God damn it, of course now there's two. Good. I hate when there's two of those. Die. Freaking. Die, man. I can't deal with you guys. God damn it, I wasn't supposed to aggro you. God damn it. good. How many times does this boss die? Like, holy hell. Doesn't take long for it. Like, all of the, like I said, every single time you hear that bell toll, the boss is dead. It's a little, like, it's a nice mechanic overall. It was in Dark Souls 1 as well. Thunderstone plate ring. Over there we cannot enter yet. Yeah. This area. Oh man. It's gonna be so much fun. Oh, I completely forgot about you. Twinkling Titanite. Alright. I think. Yeah. You are an item. So many Titanite scales and stuff. I'm so happy. Happy, happy, happy. Alright. Then there's this. God dang it. Again! Boss is dead. Get on over here. Like I said, I hate these things. They're like rolling. Animation is so out there. It's ridiculously hard to avoid it. Rolling animation, it is so hard unless you like roll, but don't try to like, even though it's like they're coming so slowly at you, even if it's like that, roll away, because if you try and avoid them by walking, you're pretty much just telling them to hit you. Hello, dragon. And so there is a dragon. How do we deal with this dragon, is my question. I used to do it this way. I used to use my bow on it. But now, I'm not so sure if we are even able to. With 44 bow arrows, I don't think it's possible when it does only 10 damage. Alright, I think what we need to do is actually like run past this. I think we did fine. Yep, I think we did fine. We did totally fine there. Now we need to run past here before this does anything, and now we have this guy. Phew. Get old. Phew, that was like really well done there. Really well done. Richard's rapier. So that's basically Richard right there. Whew, alright. We've done a real good job here. Honestly. We progressed well into the Archdragon Keep. And this is the bonfire, which is good. Everything should be quite great at the moment. We are in a good position, so I'm going to quickly go into our filing shrine here and level up. We might have maybe 1 point left. I don't want to go anywhere too high. I think we are, yeah, we have one level to put into something. And what I'm thinking here is that we put that one level to, not sure if attunement is the correct. Let's put it to attunement. I mean, it increases our FP, so it's fine. Now we are kind of balanced overall, so it's fine. Alright. If you liked the video, hit that like button. If you didn't, you know what to do. And as always, guys, stay awesome. I'll see you guys on the next episode. So, for now, bye-bye.